guys, this has been my tutorial for how to build a cool looking blacksmith shop. I'm happy with the way it turned out, and I can't wait to keep working on it and start taking advantage of it. What is going on, guys? UTC here, back in yo life, and we are here at my place on Craig's Island. Got actually not a lot going on since you saw me last. I've been gathering materials, and either next episode or later in this episode, we're going to work on that blacksmith shop up over there. But today, I am about to meet one of my server mates, Lady M, who you guys have met. She raced Gallimimuses with us, and she and I did Survival of the Fittest together. I'm sure at some point, other than that, she has popped up in a video. But Lady M is a breeding machine, no, dino breeding machine, I should be specific, and that is an aspect of the game she has really gotten into. And with all the stuff that I do taming with Mick and Chris and building around this island, I don't know when I'm ever gonna get into breeding of dinosaurs. It's complicated. I think you gotta put them together, make them wander, and then they lay eggs, and then you collect the eggs, and then you put them in the fridge until you need them. Hell, we don't even have a fridge. And then when you want to hatch the egg, you take it and you have to get it at just the right temperature, and then it hatches and you get a little juvenile or a little baby dinosaur that becomes a juvenile, that becomes like one step from an adult, that becomes an adult. All that crap is so way over my head. But there's a dino I need that is really hard to tame. You guys have seen him in my collaborations with Mick and Chris, and with Lady M and Cryo in the first video, the Quetzal. It's the biggest flying dino. Looks like, yeah, it looks like, sorry, that's Lady M messaging me. Yeah, it's like just a giant cross between a bird and a pteranodon, almost. And they are massive. They can pick up almost every creature on the island. I was flying one and picking up stegos with it in the shark taming episode with Mick and Chris. And Lady M is either, she's got some that she's bred or she has a spare one, but we're going to make a deal. She's going to come over here with her Quetzal and probably the one that's for sale. And we're going to make her an offer and see if she accepts, and we will do the deal. So give me a minute, guys. I'm going to come back with you. I am going to be hanging with Lady M, and we're going to be making a used car salesman type deal for a giant flying dinosaur. What's up, Turtle? How you doing, brother? All right, I'll be back with you guys in just a minute. So this is Deadpool?
Yes.
Cool. And this is a Quetzal. I was just talking about them in my intro. Just a giant mohawked bird.
It is.
Yeah. So, Lady, we got to make a deal for this guy.
Uh-huh.
And I know you mentioned some things that you need. This is where I keep most of my stuff, but we can make a deal. Anything you really need that I have. I have nothing in here. That's just some, like, wood building parts. I've got, like, recipes and crap in there.
Your armor's pretty cool.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
It flows right off your back, huh?
Yeah. Well, that's, you know what? That's a decent deal if you want some solid gold armor. Yeah, but have a look. Let's see if there's anything else that'll... This is so... It's got about, well, almost 500 ingots in it. And then I'm sure I have a lot more in here. I just did a big run. I borrowed a Quetzal. And after I borrowed it, I decided I needed it.
Yes.
I have...
It's a game changer.
I have a couple stacks of... less than a stack of obsidian. I have a bunch of gunpowder, cementing paste, narcos. If you just... Yeah, you let me know what you think will complete the deal. That thing's full of armor, including some purple
stuff.
It's
purple. I love purple. You know I love purple.
I do, yeah. That's my... I don't even know. Is that... That might be like a higher level armor than I currently have. What is it?
It's flak.
It's all primitive. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I only have primitive flak. But it is all purple. And you know what? If that's the thing that'll convince you, then I have some extras to throw in on top of that. Let's see what else
you
I
do.
Have. Yeah. Here. I'll just throw them in this cupboard. You keep looking in the cupboard. Ready? All matching tools.
Wow.
Wait, you're gonna have to take some out so I can keep putting them in. Everything matches. I'm a bit of a geek like that. Here, let me take some stuff out.
Oh wow. Okay. Let me get some shoes. I feel like I'm taking too much.
No. That's my extra set. I only ever even use it when this stuff breaks or I die.
But I'm like, yeah, you know me. I like purple.
Yeah. Your old armor was purple or a purple and red combo. And this, I'll tell you.
Oh, I don't want to take your tools, though.
Oh, no, that's... no. Look. Look at this. Matching tools for this armor. Solid gold pick. Solid gold
axe. Oh, look at you!
Solid gold pike. Wait. Let's see if I even have a solid gold crossbow. Dang right I do.
Oh, look at you. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. So that's a
you
deal.
You are fancy.
That's an easy deal. Oh, it's raining. Check this guy out, guys. I just made the deal for him with Lady M, and I think after editing that up, it's a pretty short little... chunk of this video. We're gonna work on the blacksmith shop. I'll head over there. I'll get all set up, guys, and then we will just build, and I'll talk to you while I build. All right, guys, so this is it. Now we're gonna try something different. I went ahead and built a rough version of this out of thatch. I gotta figure out how much of it I like, but it's a work in progress, and it's mostly gonna be built out of stone. And I have gone ahead and done some work. Check all this out. So we are going to start with that little add-on section, which is going to be made from, what did I say? I think from wooden walls, sloped stone roofs, maybe three of them. I think three of them. I don't know how many walls I'm going to need. Is that all the wooden walls I have? I guess so. I guess I probably counted it out. Over there, we are going to put one of our fireplaces, one of our forges, and one of our smithies. Yes. Okay. So I think that's what we need to start that section. And I'm going to go ahead and put all that stuff on my bar. I probably won't need any more of, you know, I won't need my crossbow. I won't need half this stuff. So... do I still have meat? All my meat went bad. Dang it, I gotta work out a better solution. Soon, too, while we're at it. Okay, so smithy. Okay, let's try this out, guys. I think it's been a while since I did some on-camera building, and we're gonna make sure we do some of that today. So the real key with these is I want, yeah, that texture facing me. Beauty. And we'll see it. Whoops, that's not right. We'll see how far we can get. I'm kind of going off an image that I have. It's partially an image in my mind, but I've been inspired. I was actually, you look for inspiration in the weirdest places when you're a builder in a video game. I've done it with Minecraft and I do it with this, but I was looking at like medieval tabletop miniatures. Come on, get placed there. Why is this one giving me such a hard time? Boom. Baba. Oh, you SOB. Why you flip backwards? Okay, we're gonna have to make extra supplies then. Shoot. So let's see, that looks perfect. No complaints there. And then this is the one section, that I kinda hate. I kinda hate because I wanted this to follow the curve of the ground. Like I wanted this to be a little outdoor sort of blacksmithing area, and this is where we'll put a smithy, a fireplace, and a forge. But what happens now is that you get this crap sticking out the top. Check this out. But it's the only way I could get it the way I like. So we'll see how it looks with the stone sloped roof in there. And you know what? Before we do, just in case it freaks out, I'm going to grab the sloped wooden roof and a couple of stone pillars. And we'll get this thing finished off. Yes, totally this one, right? Yeah. Beauts. Beauty, beauty, beauty. I love it. Okay, sloped stone roof. Do your thing. Oh yeah, that sticks out more. I thought it would. The thatch is the one that has sort of the highest profile. But that's all right. Maybe we'll put walls on top of that, like railings on top of it or something. Boom. Oh, I thought you were going to give me a hard time. Okay, so now we just need to do pillars. And then we can start placing. Yeah, that's one. And... that's one. Perfect. Well, not quite so perfect. I don't like how it sticks out, but... oh, Reaver's on. Cool. Reaver, it lives just down the way. There's this crazy Stonehenge formation if you keep following the coast out there. And he's got some stuff going on there. I think he said he's building a citadel. So this, I want... Oh no. My plans aren't going to work. This needs to be placed on a floor. And if I'm not crazy, now that I think about it, so does a forge. What about a smithy? Shoot. Okay, well, let's see what we can make happen. I'm sure you can do it on a ceiling, right? Or we just make this outer part for storage. But I really wanted to build a fireplace out here. Let's see what we can do. Let's see what we can make happen. Let's grab some wooden ceilings, which I know are. I'm just rating from our future build. That's a sloped. Okay, let's see if we got wooden ceilings hiding in one of these freaks. Yes. So we'll need at the most three, but I'm not sure I can even make that work. But we'll see. I forgot that that's the case. So we'll see with number three what the options are. Oh yeah, you would be in a totally different spot. Well, what if we place the first one and we'll see what happens? Can I go lower than that? No, we'll place the first one. Maybe we'll add a ramp to that, and then we'll see if we can place one in line with this. Yes, I can. Can I do one more? Tell me I can do one more over here. I can't, but that's close enough. So what I'll do is I'll either make this. Yeah. So we're gonna. I've got it figured out. Don't worry about me. I don't think I got this thing unlocked. So we want some wood. Fence foundations and then three extra wood walls. I don't see fence foundations. And do you have the walls? Oh, you know what we should do before I do any of that is make sure that you can even place this because it said requires placement on a floor. Okay, it will work on there. Okay, so let's try and find some fence foundations and some extra walls. So I'll take one, two of these. And who got the fence found? I think Mikey got the fence foundations. Mikey or Donnie? Yes, Mikey's got them. Okay, so what I was about to do. Did I do it? I did. Okay, so we'll put one of these. Oh, okay. Yeah, I want you down here. Right, and when you do this, it means you can place. It's easier to build walls off. So we'll do that, and then we'll take two wooden walls. Oh, you don't want to play along, do you? Okay, well, at least it looks like these are supported now. So that's going to be the way it's going to be. So, what do we want to make sure we get out here? Because if I can't do a ceiling, like where's the. Yeah, see, it won't let me place one there, so. Or there. Okay, so I just can't place one here. So, we're not going to be able to have anything here. And I don't think we can fit a fireplace, which I have two of. If we have an extra smithy, it'll go inside. And I guess out here it'll just be for looks. I was gonna place this kitty corner like that. Yeah. So we'll do that. And we'll back up. And that looks good. That's kind of what I had in mind. I was gonna do it in this corner, but that's not an option. And then we'll take. I guess everything out here will just have to be for decoration, unless I can somehow fit a forge and a smithy. I might be able to. I might. Okay, let's place the smithy first and see how much we can cram in here. Oh, you don't want to play at all, do you? Okay. I don't know what to do. Give me a minute to work with this outdoor part, guys, and then we'll finish this episode up by working on the big build. I'll be back with you. All right, guys. So it's a bit crammed. It's a bit cramped, but we managed to get the fireplace, a forge, and a smithy out here, and we've got all the same stuff for inside. But what we're gonna need is a ton of stone walls, windows, roofs. All right, guys. So I am geared up, probably too geared up, but I'll show you. My main idea for this build is to have the outer texture of the stone face inward, like I've done with the thatch. Hopefully the thatch will give it the guide that it needs to start. But what we're gonna do is throw in, we'll start with a door frame. In my head, the door was in the middle, so I might, whoops, might not be totally prepared. Yeah. I might not be totally prepared for this. So we're gonna do that. And then I only have three of these window pieces. I was thinking I would put them in the middle here. Whoops. I think I got a flip. Do I have it even selected right now? Okay. And we'll flip ya. So that'll look like that. And then ideally, I'll have one more for the center here. So there'll be windows all along the way. But maybe we'll do a back door. Yeah, maybe that's a plan. So at the moment, I'll set it up like... Frick. Frick. Okay. Well, I'll have to flip that one around. It can be so tricky with this game. As soon as you have something the way you like it, it just flip-flops on you. It's a pain in the butt. Okay, so that looks right. And it is right. Okay. So let's do the same damn thing over here. That looks right. And it is. This is the one that will have to be flipped. But we'll figure that out. Let's grab the other side. The right side. Which is... Yep. So we'll do that. Perfect. And we'll do the same thing over here. Okay, I like it. And now we're on to the standard stone walls. And we'll just have to keep doing what we do and making sure. Screw it. Making sure the right side faces out. So whatever, I got extras of these. So we'll flip that. And I think it must have to go like, ah! Why would you flip and then I flip you? Okay, fine. There you go. That's what it's going to take, I guess, is a lot of effing around. Okay, so that's wrong. We'll flip you. Beauty. Okay. I'll keep it up. Hold on. Okay, and we'll flip you. Yep. Okay, see, building on camera, I love doing it. I'd love if I were better at it, but I love doing it. And this blacksmith shop has been waiting way, way too long for this kind of love and attention. It's just been a hollow thatch frame. Boom. Okay. And we're gonna... Ooh. God, just look at your bar, dude. I'm crafting things I don't need. So we're just gonna go ahead and do this for now. I think I have enough of what I need, but we'll keep it going. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have what we need. So I'm gonna put these down. I should be exactly where I'm supposed to be, with the exception of those windows, assuming that all these place properly. So we'll go here. Oh, that's not right. Like that. Yes. Alright, and I just gotta place... Do I not have it picked? There we go. That's right. Just like that. Oh, it's off-center. Oh, that might be... I might be too picky for this. Oh, I don't want to take it down either. Alright, let's risk it. Alright, good. And nothing collapses. Okay. So, it's because I have foundations here, it's not sure whether to lock on to the foundation or the fence foundation. And I'll show you why I've gone and done the fence foundation there. That looks right. No. Like that. Nope. God, see how freaky it is? In and out of the right position. Click. Oh, what the... Seriously? Did that place... That placed up here, didn't it? Oh, God. I hate Ark sometimes. I tell you what, guys. Now I don't have enough to complete the... Okay. That's right. Okay. We're gonna have to fly up and demolish that at some point. And so, how many walls do I need now? What I was gonna do is go ahead and place them with the opposite texture down here. Because we're gonna do... You know what? Let's just do the foundations first and see if it's necessary. God, with all this crap, I can't see what's going on here. We'll place this one out here. Alright, and I got four left somehow. I must have miscalculated the size of this building. Perfect. I think I thought it was 3x4, and it's 3x3. Okay, so we get extras of those. If I need to, I can place them, get the resources back. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and replace these, and that'll get us some resources, maybe enough to build a window frame or two. Two. And I'll place these extras. And God, the rubble that's in here is mind-boggling. Okay, so let's see now if I have enough to make I'm encumbered. So window, yeah, wooden window frame. Okay, I can make more than I need. So we'll do that, and we'll put them in, and then we'll start placing the windows. So you can take the 7 slot. And now, the key with this is not messing it up again. So that's wrong. You want to do that. Okay, and it looks like it's placed in the wrong spot, but I think I can live with it. I might be able to live with it. We'll see how it looks from the outside, because look, the thatch is still there. You know what? We can make extras. Let's go ahead and demolish, and hopefully nothing comes crashing down on my head when I do this. And we'll demolish you. Too much of a perfectionist, guys. I can't let this go in this weird-looking state that it's in. But this is how you get messed up with those foundations, is you place them, and then they'll lock into the wrong thing. Or just flipping things around can mess you up, too. So that looks right to me. And it is. So what do I have left in my inventory? Stone walls, which I may not need if this looks good. Yeah, it does look good. So what I was going to do is try and place on the outside of it. Oh, I see what's messing it up. There's still thatch walls there. Wooden fence. Maybe if I bring that down, the wall will come down. Okay, no, I need to get at these thatch walls, which I can't get at now. Oh, what? That's a mess. That's a frickin' mess. Okay, well, maybe we'll place the walls in front of it, and we'll just do that. Yeah, that's neat. Okay, so I'll just replace that foundation, and I might not have to. We'll see. I'll place a wall like that, and let's see if I can just go ahead and craft one. Nope. There you go. Okay, so I need one foundation, which I do not have, but Mikey is chock full of them. All right, hang tight with me, guys. We are making some progress, I'll tell you that much. Put that window frame away, because we're going to have to figure out how to make that look good. So let's see if I can get one more down here. Yes, I can, if I know what I'm doing, and I clearly don't, because that is not lining up the way it's supposed to. That's all right. We'll try it. We'll see if I can still get a wall there. Hopefully, it'll replace the thatch wall. And it... What? Okay, fine. I'll make another one. You think I care? It placed backwards inside the block. There's some weird things. This game has to figure out its building. But, oh! Okay, no problem. No problem. It doesn't infuriate me at all. Perfect. That's the look that I was originally going to go for. It looks good from the side. I'll tell you that. Except this wall is not correct. This thatch wall. All right. We'll mess around, guys. Let me figure out my perfectionism, and I'll come back to you in a minute, okay? Yes. I think that's perfect. Okay. Guys, this build is slowly coming together. Let's take a look at it from the back. This thing will absolutely get a good coat of paint, and we'll get a good color scheme going. I'm thinking shades of gray, as it is a blacksmith. That seems like... Oh, I still have to break that wall down. Seems like that's the way you would do it. I also threw in some of these reinforced windows. Let's see if I have... I do have the resources to make another, and we'll finish that up. So I'll throw that in there, and I'll just try and burn through everything that's left in my inventory here on our way to finishing this thing. So I'm going to put one here. Let's get on the inside, and we'll see how this looks. I think we want that texture. Yes, that feels good to me. And door frames, I got a couple left. So we'll do like that, and I guess I'll have to smash this thatch to see how these walls line up. They line up great. Okay. Things are starting to go smoothly, which is bizarre. I'm sure it won't last very long. Let's go ahead and break the wall and see if we can get this lined up. I'm not sure we can. I got some weird things. They don't quite line up the way they're supposed to here, and I can't fix it. despite trying and trying over and over again, I somehow managed to get this window in there, and it's the right way. So maybe if I keep working at it, I can do it. But for the time being, I just want to get there, there, click. Yowz! Okay, now what I also have is a stone railing to replace this wooden one. So, I think I may have to take the wooden one down first to avoid... No, I saw green there. Okay. All right, let's keep it up. No, it doesn't want to play along, does it? I saw it for a second, the green. I wonder if it's got to do with where I've placed these chests. Like, maybe the wooden and the stone railings have a different size? Like, it doesn't collide with the other, but if I place the stone, it does? No? Okay. Looks like I'm going to be able to do the stone here. I just had to get rid of the wood foist. Boom. Okay, so what do I have left? We just have to do the roof and place the rest of the gear. So let me throw whatever I don't need into these dinos. Because we'll use it. Eventually we'll use it. Oh, I'll save those doors. We'll place the doors. It's really just that you can have and take it and get lost. Okay, beast. I don't know. Let's go ahead and place the hatch frames. Oh, yes. Perfect. They have a better look to them anyway. Ooh, although that's a weird shift that it's doing. Here, let's see if I can get this one placed in the exact same spot as the last one. Ooh, or does it go there? I think it goes there. And then you are gonna have to go, I guess, there. Oh, and what? And you leave the wood one, fool? Oh, inventory too heavy to jump. Dang it, I can't even fix that, can I? Alright, well, we'll fix it after we place these wall frames. I heard somebody going running outside. I hope it's not like a wild raptor. Okay, that didn't place. Let's place you now. Okay, that didn't place. Alright, I guess we're breaking roof first. This game is so freaky with its building sometimes. Just things don't add up. There's like weird snap points and things flip around on you at the last minute if you move your head 1 degree to the left or right. All right, you better place, and you better place the way I want you. That looks right. Okay. And do these beams line up? They do. I don't think we're gonna get that lucky. Oh, wood trapdoor ceiling. I still can't jump. Okay. We're gonna have to go ahead and, like, things will place on top of each other, which is bizarre. Bizarro. Let's place that, and let's place this, and we'll see how they look. Lining up wise. Okay, so you two don't line up. And you two don't either. And what I am gonna do while we're here is take some of the forges. You see, I got four. I'm gonna put one each behind these doors. So, like a show. And rotate you until you're facing me perfectly. So yeah, we're just gonna have extra forges hidden out through the back this way. Until you can't perfect place you and rotate you. Come on. Oh, yes. There we go. I like it. All right, and we'll get one more going right over here. And then we'll place one in the main room. I think that's what I was thinking. But I don't know how that's gonna work with bookshelves. Unless I do bookshelves all along this wall, I won't be able to because of the sloped roof, will I? Let's see how the bookshelves look. I think if you place them before you placed your roof, you can make it work. Let's see where you'd want to be. Okay. Oh yeah, you're going to work. Alright, and let's see how much you're sticking out from the wall. Sticking out pretty good. But it is what it is. Let's just keep placing them and hopefully these will line up next to each other. Nah, I got it, and I got it real quick. The bookshelf, guys, is made for blueprints and trinkets and just the kind of crap that you want in your blacksmith shop. So we obviously got lots of forges, and what I want to set up next, I got to figure out if we can squeeze another fireplace in here. Now, I've gone and placed those window walls there. That's the natural spot to put a fireplace. Oh, it doesn't like that at all, does it? Could do one right there. I think that's pretty cool. I mean, you block that one bookshelf a little, but let's get as close to the wall as we can get. I think like that. Okay, and we get a second fireplace. How weird's that smokestack? I don't think it'll look that weird. Smokestack's always off center on buildings, or often. What do you call it? A chimney. I can't even see the dang thing, so it ain't gonna matter. God, I am so heavy. I am so cut filled with gear. Let's try and place the rest of these roofs, and we got to get one more forge into this little dump of a blacksmith shop. So give me a minute, guys. Let me do some work, and I'll come back with you. Oh, and I'm gonna have to take Forest King and walk him and these parasaurs out of the way so we can get a good look at it. So follow me, boys. Follow me over this way. We'll park by Bogart the Rap. And what am I dying of? Food. That explains it. Let's just eat some rotten meat like a fool. That should fill up my hunger bar. And I am tough enough that I can survive it. Okay, this looks good. It's more cramped than I was thinking, but maybe we can squeeze storage or something over here. And then, no, probably not with the sloped roof. And then inside, bookshelves made for trinkets, trophies, and, ooh, I might get rid of that bookshelf. I think I like just having three. Yeah, that's too crammed. Demolish. That fireplace looks a little bit more at home. We could maybe put a forge or something in the corner. Let's see what I have in my inventory. Forge, not gonna fit. Not gonna fit. No. But, oh, it's not gonna fit in here either, is it? Oh, what a mess. Okay. So maybe I just need to have one door that gives you access to that forge area. And I think what we're gonna do is, I think if I do it right, I'll just replace the whole process. No, that didn't work at all. Why? Why are you so fussy? All right, guys, I'm gonna need some time to finish this, and you know what? I'll go away from camera and I'll do the paint job on it too. I'll come back to you when this whole dang build is done. All right, guys, this is it. I lied. I don't think I'm gonna paint it today, because this build has taken a little longer than I thought, and I'm not sure I have time to paint it and come back with you guys to give you a full tour. So I'm just going to give you the tour. We've got this little work spot out here. You've got a fireplace, a forge, and a smithy. The one thing I do need to find a way to incorporate is a couple more smithies. You can see them on my hotbar, but gone ahead and done the front here with that reverse of the stone texture. I think these are mostly in the right spot. There's a couple that are slightly out of place, but I gotta limit my perfectionism. Got reinforced windows, reinforced door. Close this behind me. I've gone ahead and squeezed a bed in here. We got storage on the inside of this. You got forges, faux days, all kinds of forges. Bookshelves that will eventually house all our engrams. We got another forge, another fireplace. And that's pretty much it, guys. What I've gone ahead and done. One thing that we'll need that I don't yet have is a mortar and pestle. So I've gone ahead and added a little deck on the back. You can see here we've got a table, a bench, and a couple of the mortar and pestle. What I'm thinking to get extra forges is I might do the same thing and have a deck on this side, or I may expand this one and make it bigger. But we'll see. That's something I can work on in the future, as I can do with the paint job. But that's gonna do it, guys. This has been my tutorial for how to build a cool-looking blacksmith shop. I'm happy with the way it turned out, and I can't wait to keep working on it and start taking advantage of it. We're so crammed in my little cabin over there that having this build is going to be great for business. I love it. So geeks, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for checking out this episode of Ark Survival Evolved. I'm Unite the Clans, and this has been my blacksmith's shop build. I will see you freaks in the next episode.
Yeah! Alright!
There we go.
There we go. Yeah.
Alright. Which way are we looking?
Tribe? Turn off?
Yeah. Beautiful cryo. I like it.
Whoa!
Oh, we did it!